Ocean Tracking Network is really establishing a completely new and unique ocean observing system, one that really is centered on understanding animal movements, migration, survival in relation to changing ocean conditions, and with the premise that you cannot really have a full understanding of the ocean and what's happening unless you understand everything about it, not just its physical and chemical properties, but also the inhabitants that we have depended upon for centuries. Something about the sea always captivated me, and I was always really torn between whether I should follow in the paths of Jacques Cousteau or whether I wanted to work on land animals. And in the end, I sort of combined both, because my greatest interest was really what kind of animals had the weirdest sorts of adaptations physiologically, because I am a physiologist by training, in order to adapt to their environments. And the marine environment just poses so many complex problems for animals. Lydia the great white shark is sort of a favorite of the Ocean Tracking Network. She was tagged in Jacksonville, Florida in May of 2013 by some collaborating researchers in the U.S. as part of the OSEARCH program. And the fascinating thing was, since that time, she has gone out into the open ocean, circled around Bermuda, gone up to the northeast coast of the U.S., gone back to Florida, and then made a beeline up to Newfoundland. I mean, the way she's using the ocean is just an incredible example of what we didn't know about great whites and the fact that they're entering much colder waters than we thought. The other thing that really interests us about Lydia is that I, for instance, have had a long study of gray seals on Sable Island and have studied them during a period of unprecedented population growth. That growth has now resulted in new colonies of gray seals being established farther south, now off the coast of America. And so Lydia now, we believe, is really kind, Lydia and her buddies are probably making their way towards Sable Island, where it's really just an incredible buffet of food available to them. When we first started discovering that the incredible movements of some of these animals, I think it at first sort of blew our minds. I mean, the first treks of the northern elephant seals all the way from California going up into the Alaska Current, patterns of northern fur seals coming down from the Bering Sea out into the North Pacific Ocean and staying out there all winter, gray seals going all over the place. Even polar bears are finding that even though they're designated as subpopulations, they make some huge long-distance migrations. And so it really makes you have to completely revise your thinking about the ecosystems that they impact or that you have to manage in response to that. Really, the ocean truly is global. And when we began to track some of these animals and find out some of these enormous migrations that they make, we began to understand that there's no way that you can think in a context of a national boundary or even a regional boundary. And we are learning ever more that we really have to manage the ocean and understand it as one ocean.